I want to introduce you. You probably don't need an introduction here, but Yahoo Finance has named our next guest the top influencer to follow in 2020. She has an honorary star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. I think that's kind of like my doctorate. For special achievement in social media, she has sold out events around the world. She's a comedian, social media superstar, renegade entertainer. Her name is Nicole Arbour.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm so good. I always defend you. People always make Colonel Sanders jokes, and I'm always like, guys, I don't see it. Leave it alone. And then I walk in here, and you look...
like Colonel Sanders. Yeah.
Like, can you not afford a whole jacket, sir? Yeah. I heard you have some money. Yeah. This is dumb.
You know, I'm actually kind of pissed at it, because everybody has played Colonel Sanders.
Yeah.
And,
Mario,
I mean, look
Lopez.
At me. I was born to play Colonel Sanders.
Yeah, you should have shown up like that to the audition.
Yeah. So, Nicole, you've been controversial for a long time because you're very outspoken. You're obviously not afraid of anything, and we're going to do a podcast, so I'm going to spend 90 minutes with you or more, because your background story, the story of how you got to where you are today after such... an amazing teen in early 20s.
Yeah.
Is remarkable.
Thanks.
When did you, I saw something with you, you said the other day that something about, you know, you don't have to spend too long to realize that, you know, all the Hollywood people are douchebags.
Yeah. Yeah, it's true.
Yeah. So, but you were part of that for a while. When did this change happen to you and you had the balls to come out and say, you guys are all frauds?
Well, I saw the man behind the curtain, and I went to Oz. I was invited to all the parties. I was at the Oscars. I apparently am a documentary that I was included in, won 3 Emmys the other day. And I just was like, all right, that's cool. Like, I just saw who these people really are. And I saw that every charity they pretend to support, they don't support that charity. They show up to the event to walk the red carpet, to get their photo taken, to wear a dress that's $20,000, donate zero to the actual charity, and then just do an interview that says, I support this. Like, all of them were fraudulent human beings. Like, they don't have any values. Their only value is the dollar, and they don't care how they get it. Everything that I care about in my life, they don't care about.
Your friends, because when you first had a friend... because you were a friend.
I have one.
When you first had that friend.
Yes, yes.
You were in 2016. You were like I was. I was against Donald Trump in 2016. And you were as well. And you went over to a friend's house and they said,
she's a Trump supporter.
Hi, you know, me and my family were Trump supporters. And you immediately thought,
you're a garbage human. I was like, oh my gosh, you're a homophobic, sexist, racist, which I've said before was weird because her boyfriend is a black man who a little gay. he's a dancer, whatever. my bad. I was like, whoa, Nicole, that's a you thing for you to automatically assume that this person is XYZ because you've been told to think like that. And then I've told the story before that I was speaking at USC like the night or the 2 nights before the election. And I was just supposed to be there speaking about social media and its effect on the elections. And they wanted me to say that I'm voting for Hillary and that I would. And I was like, no, I'm not going to say that to the students. And they're like, we strongly suggest you say this to the students. And it was people from Hillary Clinton's campaign.
Oh my God.
And I was like, you mofos, like, you can't tell. I don't know if you guys have watched my videos to them. You can't tell me what to do because now I'm going to go do the opposite.
Right.
It feels like you're shady people. And then when I was on stage, they took the mic and they were like, you know, Nicole was just backstage saying she was going to vote for Hillary if she could.
And I was
like, game on, flip table. Mm-hmm. Now you guys have an enemy. Let's go. And I was just like, that is so wrong. And that was like my first little inkling that this Hollywood crowd aren't who they say they are. And then as more and more has come up the last few years, I'm just standing there like my arms out. I'm like, I told you so. I feel like I'm in Spartacus or something. Yeah, I'm ready to go to war. Let's go.
I saw your video where you expose yourself.
Yes.
You're the only person that I have ever met that understands that superpower.
Thanks. I M&M'd myself. Yeah.
It's the great, I'm a, raging recovering alcoholic.
I've heard.
I've made every mistake you could possibly make, and I've always been open.
Yeah.
And when I had people, you know, come after me and they're like, "We're going to destroy you." I had my audience already knows everything.
Yeah.
I mean, I've got nothing to hide. And it is a superpower.
You it's think freeing.
It is. You yeah. think those things will destroy you. You spend your whole life going, if people only knew this or that. Everybody's alike.
Oh,
everybody's the same.
I love it. I have, you know, Go Team Academy, which we can talk about on your podcast. But this is something I teach people to do, is like, put all of your junk out there in front. Whoever doesn't back you after they know you as a real person doesn't deserve to be in your life.
Right.
They automatically just cut themselves. Make
yeah.
the cuts.
Yeah.
Get a better team.
Yeah, exactly.
It's good.
Right.
If you have to act all day, which is what I see in Hollywood, people are acting from the moment they wake up to the moment they go to bed. That's not a real life. It's not fun. And that's why you're depressed and on drugs.
I think that's why most people live their whole life that way.
Mm-hmm.
That they're, you know, one of the best things that ever happened to me, I hate to tell this to my children because I want them to live around me, but one of the best things that ever happened is I moved across the country away from my family. Where I was with my family, I was always the stinky little brother.
You know what that happened to them
yeah.
too.
Yeah, thank
fair,
you.
Fair.
But you get to be your own person.
Yes.
And when you really dig in to find out who you are, not who everybody has said you are.
Yep.
But who you really are, life changes,
mm-hmm.
and it's really good.
Yeah, and I have family members right now who wouldn't agree with me being on your show, for example, because they have different.
Well, they suck. You should cut them out.
I agree. No, I'm just kidding. I can't do that. Merry Christmas, guys. I'm gonna say Merry Christmas because that's what I believe. But yeah, I know people that'd be like, "What are you doing over at the Blaze or Blaze Media, whatever?
Yeah.
Blaze Media. I don't know what it's called yet.
Blaze.
It's not Blaze. It's definitely not." But I'm just like, yeah, this is who I am. Take it or leave it. And I think by us living as good human beings, and we don't always have to be angry and fighting on Twitter and in the press and whatever, be the good guys. And then it's kind of like what Martin Luther King Jr. used to do. It's like, be the good people so that when people are coming against you, they automatically look like the jerks. You know, march peacefully, wear a suit, look good, be intelligent.
How many people get this? How many people
yeah.
get this?
Not enough.
Not enough.
Maya Angelou was the same.
I have been preaching this for I don't know how long, and everybody's like, well, it's time to get up and start. No, you don't play that. You never win.
You don't, you can't roll in the mud and not get dirty too. Don't get me wrong, it's fun. It's like,
because you do roll in the mud.
Well, I do roll in the mud, but I see it as my, like, this is my blood sport. It's like, okay, you guys, SNL, you're really Pete Davidson? You're going to go after small businesses. I'm the daughter of a small business entrepreneur. Like, my dad's a blue collar guy, ran his own thing. That would be my dad if we lived there, that he's going after. I take it personally. Pete, let's go. You know, like, if I put my gloves on, SNL, you're not funny. We're going to go at it and I'm going to beat you.
It is so amazing because. No surprise to you. You're very beautiful.
Thanks.
You were a cheerleader.
Yeah.
And you still are really happy and bubbly and everything you think of as a cheerleader, but you are a slugfest fighter, which is so great.
Thanks.
It is so great.
It's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
You know, stand up for yourself. And I have this like superhero thing in me. I'm just like, I was obviously like bullied. It is such a weak word, but yeah, I was totally bullied growing up. I went through really hard times that we'll talk about on your podcast throughout my 20s and was disabled and all sorts of stuff. And I just, my eye twitches when I see bullies and I see them as open game. I was like, all right, I'm going after you. I see you going after them. I'm coming in. You can swing at me as hard as you want. I don't feel it.
I'd be afraid
to, the fire.
To challenge Pete Davidson, though, because that's 85 pounds a man you're going up against.
Of soy.
Of soy.
I'm allergic to soy, so maybe he's got me. Yeah.
Nicole Arbour, she is going to be she's going to be with me on the podcast. I think, is it going to air this week or when we get back? I don't know. I'm really excited to have the conversation with you.
Me too.
So thank you so much for being here. Can follow her at nicolearbour.ca. Come on.
Nah. Follow me on Twitter at Nicole Arbour. Instagram, letter I, letter B, Nicole Arbour.
Okay.
Yeah.
thank you for being here. Appreciate it.